where we are. So we totally missed the extra magic hours, but that's okay, because we're off to see Chippendale at Garden Grill. So yes. Let's go find them.
Food. So we're in Garden Grill, we've been seated, we've ordered breakfast with no eggs because I don't like American eggs, they're just like rubber. So we have cinnamon bun and the fruit platter, David's got root beer, I've got apple juice, and we're just waiting for some characters. Very much looking forward to trying what's left of that cinnamon bun once David's raided it. Breakfast, no eggs, more potatoes. That's a better option. How's the bun?
Amazing. Really good. Really been looking forward to this bun.
Yeah.
Right.
Thanks. The man who worked here is looking at the micro muffin. It's a bit confusing. I just thought he was staring at my breakfast. But he must have seen that hundreds of times.
This isn't going to beat me. I have realised my final Mickey waffle. On that side, he looks quite normal. Turn him over. Chernobyl Mickey.
In the mirror.
Is that one of your relations?
I find it really awkward.
I'm shouting because I'm in the rainforest.
Whoop whoop.
David's enjoying the tater tots. Surprisingly, a tater tot in hazelnut, chocolate hazelnut sauce.
There's a winner.
It sounds to be quite nice. Yeah, Nutella and potato is the way forward, apparently.
He's got an almost matching shirt.
Hey
Dale. You've got your cousin on the top. Oh, looking good.
I'm wearing your bag.
Good night, you! Woohoo!
Close. Should have taken it out. Your monorail driver.
Take it back to a resort.
Yeah, for a nap, far from food. Yeah, I know. Let us down.
Sorry.
We're just doing film selfies today. Say hello. Hooked in the eye.
Looking good.
You have a great day, we'll see you on the monorail.
See you on the monorail.
Later.
Oh!
Chip?
How are you?
I'm wearing your. Wearing your badge today. Yeah, both of you. Oh! Chaos. Can we have a film selfie? Come on, David. Say hi to everyone.
Hello!
Hey! It's Chip! Poke him in the eye.
Your brother's driving a monorail.
On my pit. What? Let's hope not. Let us know which one it is. We'll make sure we're not on it.
Are you a better driver?
You're the best.
Channel 5 documentary, then cinnamon buns go wrong. I'm loving it anymore.
and I think that was a cinnamon bun too far.
How many did we have?
They wish they used condoms. We had one cinnamon roll, lots of sausage, no egg, devil's work, bacon. David overdid the potato barrels, and I had two waffles. And we watched the characters go through the amnesia door.
I think we're beaten, but Ian refuses to give up and wants to eat everything what's left. So it's gonna get messy.
There's so much cinnamon roll left. It's ridiculous.
So we've finished breakfast, we've looked at some pins, and we're going to go into mouse gear, and then we're off the test track, so we'll
fingers
have...
Fingers crossed it's open this time.
Fingers crossed it's open. We might do single riders, we're going to try the disability pass as well maybe, but yeah, we'll take you through mouse gear, see what's happening, and see what great things they've got. They've got some awesome pins, so I'm quite excited for this. Let's go!
Love the styling on that. I love colours, I love it. There's just something about those colours, the whole...
It just works really well.
Yeah. Not, the fact, the hat's not for me, but just the stripe and everything. Even on the hoodie. Extra large, still won't fit me. Feel how soft that is.
Oh my god, it's lovely. Look at that. That might be coming home with us.
Fridge magnet.
Fridge magnet.
It's quite hefty in a good way.
EPCOT coin. How much is that?
$29.99. Lovely heat, but it just feels a bit more humid. More humid than Animal Kingdom.
It's a lot more, I think because of all the concrete, it's quite reflective.
Oh, that makes more sense.
But yeah, there's some cool stuff in there, in mouse gear.
Yeah, the Epcot stuff, particularly Epcot Take 5. Really love the, I've always loved the Epcot 80s kind of vibe.
The colours are really
the colours
nice.
And just the design of it, it's really nice.
There's a few things we'll probably pick up. It's only day two, or full day two anyway, so... Yeah, well, we sorted out our fast passes, we hope. We went to guest relations and we saw...
Mayu.
Yeah, she was awesome. She was from Japan. She was a bit shocked when she saw our plan. and how detailed it was, so she could see that we had the fast passes booked, but they started disappearing because of the annual pass stuff, which she's promised to sort it out.
Yeah, it's because we bought a UK 14-day ticket, but we're only staying on property for 7 days. So when we upgraded the fast pass, it's quite a unique ticket apparently, so their system can't cope with if you're not staying on property for the second week, which is why everything from the second week started dropping off. But she rang the technical team and they could see what we had previously, so they said in the next 20 minutes or so they're going to go back in and add the extra stuff, or what's dropped off they're going to add that back on. So if we have any more problems, that's now been logged against our account, so we're just going to see guest relations again, which hopefully we won't have to. It does mean that it wasn't a waste of money getting the annual pass to start on the first day, so if that goes wrong again or we start getting more emails, then yeah, we'll just have to deal with it. But she was really helpful, bless Mayu, in Epcot guest relations. I was really surprised that it was as simple as it was, as painful as it was, but yeah, they resolved it.
Awesome. We'll let you know how we get on. Now off to test track.
So we've just obviously we're at test track. We've just got a disability pass, so it's 11:10 now. The standby queue is 95 minutes. We've just got a disability pass allowance, which means that we can come back at 12:31 and go straight into the fast pass queue. So until then, we'll hobble around a bit more and then back for test track at 12:30.
Boom, monorail shot.
Sat here looking at world through prison bars.
A little drinky, and now we're in Disney Traders. Aircon's good, isn't it?
Big Mac. How do you
act? So originally the plan was today to come to EPCOT for extra magic hours and then have the breakfast at Garden Grill, and then we were going to walk around World Showcase because this afternoon we're at Hollywood Studios. So we've got all of the fast passes for Hollywood Studios this afternoon because we thought we'd do magic hours this morning. But because we were tired, a bit jet lagged yesterday, and also because
peg leg.
David's got his peg leg. We just did Garden Grill. And we've not done as many rides or any rides that we thought we would. But we do have still have test track, so we'll do test track before we leave.
But we did Frozen on the first night, didn't we? So that was unexpected, and that was really good. So.
Yeah, it was. And it's closed today anyway, so we can't go on it. But our first fast pass is in Hollywood Studios at 3:30, so we've got about an hour or so left here at EPCOT, so we'll have a little mooch around the shops before we head over to fast pass, test track.
Playing car?
Oh, thank you, that's cool.
My parents?
Yeah.
I think they'd like those. They're really nice. They've got the main
four parts,
iconic
and then
attractions, yeah.
I wonder who's the queen in each, and the king. So it's Mickey and Minnie.
Haunted Mansion? That's cool.
First time you went on it, you were literally like, ooh. Oh, I feel a bit shaken. Right, I think we should get a drink. You want to get some pins, and then we need to
head home,
head back, because we've got stuff to do at Hollywood Studios this afternoon. Whew, that was a good ride. What's your favourite thing so far this morning?
Oh, the margarita was good. Not that I'm an alcoholic.
That's you've come all the way to Disney. You're at EPCOT. And the frozen mango margarita was your favourite thing.
Okay, so we're back at the back at the resort, and you can see some of the construction which is going on at the moment.
When it's finished, it's going to have a rooftop restaurant, which will be quite amazing. It's going to have, you'll have views of all the parks, fireworks. That's going to be a real must place to go for dinner, a real premium dining experience. And even though some of those rooms are going to have such great views as well.
And we're going to go through and pick up our resort mugs and grab some snacks. It's so pretty, like the planting's amazing. It's really nice, and you can see Ian's on the GoPro.
Oh my god, it's Inception.
It's filming the film. So I'm gonna take you through. So this is the noisiest bit of the resort because we're right by the tower. But it's probably also the prettiest part. So I'll take you in. And that's where we checked in, so registration. It's so pretty, it's amazing. And we've got the restaurants. Panchitos is the shop here, and the fountain.
Oh. So, We're kind of on time for dinner, but David's hobbling off like a crazy person because we just sat with a broken tram for 10 minutes and it started to rain. On the plus side, the park looks quite empty. Just not had an opportunity to take it all in because we are heading here to the Brown Derby for dinner, even though neither of us are quite hungry. But the park is looking good. It's one of the best looking parks there is. Okay. I love the sound of thunder. It's 4:25.
No, cool.
They're vibrating. Time for dinner. So it's a nice restaurant. And we sat up on a tier to look over and lord it over people. I think they got it slightly wrong. I think it should be us down there, looking up at the others. So we are in the Hollywood Brown Derby. We ate here before, last time we came, 3 years ago, and the steak was lovely. Really, we really liked it. So we've got the Fantasmic dining package. David is having steak. I'm having steak. David's having a dairy-free steak, which is not cow-free, it's dairy-free. The allergy menu mostly talked about soya and gluten, and there was one specific thing that was for dairy, but Willie, our server, said, no, that's fine, we'll make sure there's modifications. So David's now worried he's going to get some kind of Franken-steak, which may still have some kind of dairy involved in some of the accompaniments. But we'll see.
We've got a lovely server.
Yeah, who doesn't like a bit Willy? Willy for dinner.
So
Willy's this bit. David's got the laugh,
of course. Because the server's called Willy.
And we came 3 years ago. We had a lovely but crazy server.
And I can't remember what her name was, but it was one of two.
Yeah.
Also it ended in an I, and her name was under Titty. T-I-T-T-I. Funny. F-A-N-N-I. So we had a titty or a honey last year, and this year we've got a win. So it's making David giggle because he's charmed.
My salad's arrived. It's a green salad with strawberries and peach and cheese and green stuff. and all that normal stuff that goes in a salad, except it's not looking like a salad mum makes. So that's the green salad with peach and strawberry. David has a little bit of death carpaccio.
So you've seen Ian's food, and mine is the beef carpaccio.
Death carpaccio.
So Ian and I were just talking about Coronado Springs. We've now been there for two nights, and yeah, we're starting to form an opinion. I have to say the room is really nice.
It's a lovely room. It's massive. The floor's a bit crappy.
Yeah, the floor's really dirty. It's like they don't do anything with it. It's really nice. It's a nice wooden sort of laminate, but
when you walk around with nothing on your feet and then you get into bed and you see all these black prints that a burglar's been in, you're like, what the heck is that? And then you realise it's your own feet from walking around the wooden floor.
That or Ian doesn't wash his feet.
We'll never know. I'm sticking to my original story that the floor was a bit grubby, but there's lots of storage space. Safe is a good size, lots of plugs, lots of bees, a telly, bathroom's lovely, it's a bit bright, shower's great, got a Keurig coffee machine, I feel like I'm on a generation game. ice bucket cups, mini fridge, lots of pillows.
USBs!
It's a lovely room.
Oh, nice bit of death. So the steaks had arrived. David came with fries instead of the mash that I've got, so it's dairy free.
I think yours is cooked in butter as well.
Ooh, lovely. Butter, meat. Yeah, it does look good. I'm going to enjoy this. Good. Right, let's tuck in.
So the allergy menu was going quite well, up until dessert, and dessert's just arrived, and I'll show you Ian's first. So here we go, just excuse me.
I get two samples, and get a booby and a cheesecake.
I'm a cheesecake kind of guy, I'm not a booby kind of guy.
This is the famous grapefruit cake, I think.
Oh.
Mm. How is it?
Creamy. Tangy. Ooh, tastes like marmalade.
Oh. So the allergy menu is just here, so we are zooming out. Yeah, so for my $50 or so, I get a bowl of fruit, which reminds me a lot of British Airways, actually. It's a bit of a cop-out for an allergy menu, but particularly at this level, but we'll give it a go. I'm sure it's great.
It's
but that said, these desserts do look great, so I might just film these instead.
So we just finished dinner and we walked out into the Star Wars
spectacular
thing. and we've timed it perfectly because we have a fast pass now for Star Tours, so we're going to head over and a bit of hula hoop fun because they haven't opened all the attractions at Hollywood Studios yet, so they're resorting to hula hoops. It's much anticipated. I'm getting my fast pass tomorrow for that. Oh, standby is 25.
Become my apprentice, and I will complete your training.
Not on my watch. Ready position. Left shoulder. Other side.
So we're in Star Tours and glasses. And it was a walk-on. Thank you for flying Star Tours. Bye-bye. I missed that. Chewie is my co-pilot. That's a nice breeze. got right sweat on during Star Tours, always do.
You get excited.
Almost to the point at which I've got travel sickness, but that's why I like it.
All right, Dab. You want some hairy feet like a Wookiee? Yours for $9.99.
Sweaty bet.
What, the vest?
Yeah.
You should buy one and wear it.
No.
I mean, everyone needs to see
it. About to see your Wookiee.
See, these look good, but you need the patience of a saint and the tools of an ironmonger.
Oh, there's the cocaine penguins.
So just come off Star Tours and we are now going to go to Toy Story Land.
Yeah, we've got Midway Mania, or whatever it's called.
Yeah.
In just over half an hour. So it'll give us time to have a little wander and take in the sights.
Can't wait, it's going to be amazing. Let's go.
This is where everyone's going to be.
Yeah.
The rest of the park is pretty empty, so I suspect this is where most people are.
Oh, I love it.
Hey, my name is Woody. You know this toy?
It's amazing.
It's playtime.
All these two things. It's a shame I'm looking into the sun so you can't see any of us.
I'm looking forward to seeing it lit up at night.
So it's like you fell in a toy box.
Good old Slinky. Toy Story Mania looks amazing. I just waved at them as I went past, it made me a bit teary. They look so happy. A massive line. That's dedication. It's busy dedication for you.
So this is Woody's lunchbox from Toy Story 2 or 3. The one with the collectibles. It's really cool. Like, it's really amazing. I'm loving the umbrellas. And then we've got opposite that, so alien flying saucers. So the other side of the park is more Space Ranger, Toy Story, rather than Woody.
Oh, it's the alien swirling saucers, the plants, they've got purple and green ones. It's amazing.
almost in sight. About 40 minutes. We've got Midway Mania for lapping, so we're doing that next. And then we're using David's disability pass to go on Slinky Dog. But next, it's these things. We're off.
For your safety, remain seated with your seatbelt fastened, your hands, arms, feet, and legs.
Oh, is it a double? Need to loosen that off a bit. Sure. Oh, we're gonna slide. Go Slinky! Oh, I've got goosebumps. That's crazy stupid. Oh, this is a little treat. Oh my days.
What are we doing now?
Oh, we got Midway Mania, but I love that.
That was cool.
90 seconds of just gigglesome.
It reminds me of California.
It is. It's just made us whatever it is in...
it's Radiator Springs, isn't it?
Yeah.
But it's really good.
I loved it. That was worth the 45 minute wait. And thankfully it's not too hot either. But we've got Fast Pass for Midway, so we're going to go over there now. I love the music for this. There's something about the Toy Story music that reminds me of the Generation Game theme. Which I was singing in the queue the whole time. Oh,
coastline. It's Slinky, obviously.
It's exciting.
Stinky dog.
I'm a bit worried. Your sunglasses.
Might have to put them on.
That's our car. Well, that's my dog.
It's time to get in the car. You're right. I'm really anxious. I felt a bit dizzy, but I think it's a excitement.
My lap bar was down so far. Like, I feel like I winded myself. That's quite quick.
Yeah, it's good. Oh, I'm so pleased we did it on the first time we got here. And we get to do it a couple more times, hopefully. I think we've got at least one more fast pass. I can't speak. I'm hot and sweaty and anxious. I'm waiting for the launch.
Here we go.
Nothing was really unexpected. It was like,
ooh. Yeah, because you see Galaxy's Edge over there. I've got a shaky hand, look.
Oh, here they come.
Oh, it's so good.
We first walked in and there's the big, literally there is the big loop, the slinky loop. When we stood at the bottom and we were filming and I waved at people and they started going over and they waved back and I started to cry.
I'm welling up now. There's just something quite magical about the whole thing.
And now the light's setting, or the sun's setting, it's quite a lovely light. And the Christmas lights in Andy's garden are coming on.
Woody and Jesse. Well, it turned into a wonderful afternoon in the end.
You still wanted to get out, didn't you?
Yeah, it was quite stressful getting home, having a rest.
and then coming back in time for dinner, and we had problems with technology in the hotel room, and then it started to thunder. But it's really turned around. It's been really a lovely evening, and we've got Fantasmic in an hour, so we're gonna go and get some aircon and a drink and catch up later. I don't think I'll get bored of that sound, people screaming on Slinky Dog. So we just got off Slinky Dog, and then we were quite hot and wanted a drink. So we came here and we had a slush, because we then had to go for the 9 o'clock Fantasmic. Is it Fantasmic? Fantasmic. Which is the first time we've seen it. I really liked it.
It was really good. Really, really, really good.
It was just about the right length as well. I was hoping it wasn't going for too long, and I think it was good length. And you may actually see some of it before you've just seen this bit on this vlog. It depends whether or not it came out. Was filming, but I'm still not quite sure of my nighttime settings. So have you seen it and it's obvious, or you've not seen it and we just told you?
So that's our day done today. So we started off in Epcot this morning, we did Garden Grill, we Glastonbury Road Test Track, we spent some time at home, we've done Toy Story, all three yes. rides in Toy Story Land, which is pretty amazing. It was really unexpected for today. And we've seen Fantasmic, been to a Grand Derby for dinner. Oh my gosh, it's been a full day. So that's us done for today. And we're gonna sign off. And
we'll probably give you some shots of Hollywood Studios at yeah. night, which I think looks amazing.
Yeah, it's a really pretty
I'm
part.
Hoping that we can do it justice.
So we'll see you tomorrow. Great time.
Night night.